for my book, no marks for the haircut. But let's have a look at the style he shows on the ice. A real showman, good to watch. Let's hope he's really keyed up for a great performance here. And sometimes he can produce it. Aula Askelainen from the home city of Helsinki. Held it.
Tremendous height on that triple flip. He's one of the few skaters that have done what the rules say and really linked it with intricate steps. Now the combination.
Yes! Triple looks, double toe. Not the cleanest we've seen, but we've seen many worse.
People in this stadium this afternoon, but if he can go clean, the place will come to life.
One of the tallest men in the competition, in fact, the tallest, 1.87 meters. Just held on to the double axel, looked like he was going anywhere.
My heart missed a beat then, but he's clean now.
Great to watch. Well, he set the judges a problem. They didn't expect that. But Michel Lee in the middle there must have hoped for it. Wonderful stuff. It's made the afternoon. It may not be the best performance we've seen, but certainly the atmosphere was the best, and it was the most enjoyable to watch. Well done, Aula Askelainen. Are you going to party?
I think he will. And well, he might. He deserves it. What a man. Well, you could count the number of clean programs we've had this afternoon on one hand. And what a way to end this competition.
And the show started even before he started skating.
Certainly be very interesting to see what they do with the marks for Aula. There, the triple flip, and it really flew. There's no doubt about it. Good, strong running edge. He's not the fastest skater that we've seen, and not the most natural. But he really does present the program well. And, well, if there was a mark for entertainment value, you'd have to give it to him.
You would.
And
well, I hope the judges have the imagination to go with this. They would have set them a rough idea of where they thought he'd finish, but I think he's broken through that expectation.
All right.
and not bad at all. Amazingly, the Finnish judge giving 5-0, 4-8 up to 5.6, those for the elements. Now this really is exciting. It's going to put him in contention for a medal. Now, as long as the marks are as good as that, and they should be for presentation or better, there should be 4-5, 4-5, 5-5, and that will be good enough to put him in with a shout.
Well, they could certainly go up 0.1 or 0.2 for presentation. The Italian, they're down at 4.8. I'd like to see them come up.
Look at that. 5-0 up to 5.8 from Vanessa Riley and the Swiss judge. And he moves into second position. Fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. Aula Askelainen, who's never been in the top 10 in 7 European championships, comes to his home city and thrives on the adrenaline buzz. Well, we've seen him emotional before on much lesser performances than that, but he can hardly take it in what he's achieved.
That's absolutely marvellous. I mean, the guy, a great entertainer, and well, I hope he doesn't party too much because he's still got a bit of work to do.
He's got a job to do, and he's got a real chance of a medal. And we've had our criticism of the judges in the past, indeed this afternoon, what they were doing with Kostin, I can't quite work out. But they got it dead right in our book there, and they had the imagination to go with a final performance of real merit.
Absolutely, it would have been so easy for them not to give him the marks, but look at that, confirmation, Aula Jaskalainen in there in second place.
So Dmytrenko leads, Askelainen in second, Tautaroff third. But it's wide open, absolutely wide open now. Stephen Cousins drops down to ninth, but anybody could win it because Askelainen, Dmytrenko, not guaranteed at all.
Turning colder in the north with some more snow showers.